Dear students, in today's lecture, let us make an attempt to know about bed bug and its control. Introduction. Bed bug is an aeterous insect, live in human inhabited places, preferably at the vicinity or inside beds and bedding areas. The systematic position of bed bug is as follows. The bed bug belongs to phylum Arthropoda, class Insecta, order Hemiptera, suborder Heteroptera, family Simicidae, genus Simix, and species Lectularis. The family Simicidae has 6 subfamilies, and each subfamily includes different genera and species of bedbugs. They are subfamily Afrosimicinae. It includes 8 to 9 species, example Afrosimix constrictus, subfamily Cocodaminae. It includes 6 genera and 7 species, example Leptosimix species, subfamily Simicinae. It includes 5 genera and 17 species, example Simex lectularis. Subfamily Hematosiphoninae, it includes 7 genera and 14 species, example Arthocoris pallidus. Subfamily Latrosimicinae, it includes only 1 genus, example Latrosimex. Subfamily Primisimicinae, it includes 2 genera and 1 species, example Primisimex caveris. Bedbug species. The bedbugs known by a variety of other names, including wall louse, crimson rambler, chili bellies, heavy dragon, chinch bug, and red coat. Bedbug Simix lectularis is found in temperate climates throughout the world. The other Simix species feed on bat and are called bat bugs. They are Simix pipistrelli, found in Europe, Simix pilosilus, found in western US, and Simix adjunctus, found entirely in eastern US. Other species include Simix hemipterus, found in tropical regions. The Leptosimix bouti, found in the tropics of West Africa and South America. Simix pilosilus, Simix pipistrella, and Hematosiphon inodora, found in North America. By using Simix lectularis and Simix hemipterus, a hybrid Simix hemipterus versus lectularis was produced in 1988, and it was sterile. Epidemiology of bedbugs. Bedbugs were mentioned in ancient Greece as early as 400 BC. Later, they were reported by Aristotle. Bedbugs were first mentioned in Germany in the 11th century, in France in the 13th century. Pliny's Natural History has published about bedbugs in 77 AD in Rome. In this report, medicinal value of bedbugs and their usage is mentioned, and treating ailments such as snake bites and ear infections was mentioned. This belief was persisted until 18th century, when Guttard recommended their use in the treatment of hysteria. Later in England, during 1583, bedbugs were reported, and it was believed that they were brought to London in 18th century with the supplies of wood to rebuild the city after the Great Fire of London in 1666. According to a report by the United Kingdom Ministry of Health in 1933, all the houses in many areas had some degree of bedbug infestation. The increase in bedbug populations in the early 20th century has been attributed to the advent of electric heating, which allowed bedbugs to thrive year around instead of only in warm weather. Simix lectularis may have originated in the Middle East in caves inhabited by bats and humans. Thus, bedbugs have been known as human parasites for thousands of years and occur at human residing places around the world. They were common in the developed countries. Rates of infestation in developed countries varied considerably, while decreasing from the 1930s to 1980s. Increased dramatically since 1980s. At a point in the early 1940s, they were mostly eradicated in the developed countries, but have increased in prevalence since 1995. The exact cause of this resurgence remain unclear. However, it is variously ascribed to greater foreign travel, increased immigration from the developing countries to the developed countries, more frequent exchange of second-hand furnishings among homes, a greater focus on control of other pests, resulting in neglect of bedbug countermeasures, and increasing resistance to pesticides. Further, infestation of human habitat has been on the increase. Bed bug bites and related conditions have been on the rise as well. Occurrence of bed bugs. Bed bugs occur in homes, hotels, schools, retail shops, office buildings, libraries, and other public areas. They occur in more numbers and spread through society due to increased travel of people, poor awareness, and unhygienic inhabitation. Habitat. Bed bugs are parasites, feed exclusively on the blood of warm-blooded animals, and best adapted to human environments. Thus, the name bedbug is derived mainly from their preferred habitat, that is, warm houses and animals including human bedding or sleep areas. Bedbugs are nocturnal in nature, very active at night compared to day hours. They are elusive and usually show their peak activity between 10 p.m. to 6 a.m. Bedbugs occur singly or in aggregations. They found commonly in or near beds, luggage, inside of vehicles, within furniture, amongst bedside culture, inside electrical sockets and nearby laptops, computers and other warm places occupied by man. Bedbugs also nest near animals that have nested within human dwelling places such as bats, birds or rodents. They are also capable of surviving on domestic cats and dogs. Morphology of bedbugs. Adult. Adult bedbugs are light brown to reddish brown in color. The body color varies depending on its feeding. When bedbug has taken a blood meal, its color will change from brown to purplish red. They are flattened or oval in shape and have no hind wings. However, the front wings are vestigial and reduced to pad-like structures. Bedbugs have segmented abdomens with microscopic hairs that give them a banded appearance. Adults grow up to 4 to 5 millimeters long and 1.5 to 3 millimeters wide. Eggs. Eggs are small in size and measures around 2.5 millimeter. They are white or semi-transparent in color. Eggs hatch into nymphs within a week. Nymph. Newly hatched nymphs are translucent or light in color. A bedbug nymph of any age that has just consumed a blood meal has a bright red translucent abdomen, fading to brown and turns to opaque black within 2 days. Thus, they become browner as they molt and reach maturity. Nymphs are juvenile bedbugs, range from the size of a bedbug egg, that is 2.5 millimeter to the size of a full adult bug's size, that is 4.5 millimeter. It is approximately the size of an apple seed. However, nymphs are much smaller, that is 1.6 millimeter when they are in first instar stage and nearly colorless except after feeding, but resemble the adult in general shape. Aggregation and dispersal behavior. Cimex lectularis aggregates under all life stages and mating conditions. Bedbugs may choose to aggregate because of predation, resistance to desiccation, and more opportunities to find a mate. Bedbugs use pheromones and chiromones to communicate regarding nesting locations, feeding, and reproduction. Moreover, airborne pheromones are also responsible for aggregations. The male excretes an aggregation pheromone into the air that attracts virgin females and arrests other males. Reproduction. Sexual dimorphism. In bedbugs, there is no perfect and well-defined sexual dimorphism exists. However, one can distinguish male and female bedbugs by seeing their body size variations. Example, in Cimex lectularis, female is larger in size than that of male. Male has pointed abdomen with copulatory organ, while female has more rounded abdomen. Mating. Bedbug's sexual attraction is primarily based on size, and males mount any freshly fed partner regardless of sex. Sometimes, male bedbugs attempt to mate with other males and pierce their abdomens. This behavior occurs because of sexual attraction. Thus, any bedbug with a recent blood meal would become a potential mate to male. However, there are occasions where males will mount unfit, flirt females also. Males are generally unable to discriminate between the sexes until after mounting, but before insemination. Sometimes female will show disinterest for mating and curl her abdomen forward and underneath towards the head to avoid mating. Female bedbug has a reproductive tract that functions during oviposition. Male bedbug has hypodermic genitalia for insemination. Traumatic insemination. All bedbugs mate by traumatic insemination, where male pierces the female abdomen with its hypodermic genitalia and ejaculates sperms into the body cavity. In all bedbugs species except Primisimex cavernis, sperms are injected into the mesospermalage, a component of the spermalage, a secondary genitalia structure that reduces the wounding and immunological costs of traumatic insemination. Injected sperm travel via the hemolymph, that is blood, to sperm storage structures and fertilize eventually in the ovaries. Fertilized females lay 3 to 4 eggs each day continuously until the end of their lifespans. Female bedbugs survive for about 9 months under warm conditions. Life cycle. Male and female bedbugs mate with each other. After mating, female starts laying eggs. Eggs are laid in cracks or rough surfaces. After 6 to 10 days of incubation, egg hatch into nymphs. Newly emerged nymphs search for blood meal and feed at least once in every instars. Immature nymphs molt 5 times before reaching adulthood. Bedbugs complete more than 3 generations per year. Nymphs shed their skin through ecdysis. At each stage, they complete 5 instars, 6 molts, and finally attain sexual maturity. Each nymph stage lasts approximately a week, depending on temperature and the availability of food. The nymphal stage will be completed in around 2 months. All ages are found in a reproducing population. Immature bedbugs may live for several months without feeding, while adult may survive as long as 1 year without a meal. Under normal circumstances, adult bedbugs will live for about 10 to 11 months. However, the lifespan of bedbugs varies by species and is also dependent on feeding. Feeding habits. Bedbugs are obligatory hematopagous insects, feed on human blood. They also feed on other animals such as rodents, rabbits, bats, and even birds when human host is not available. At the place of inhabitation, bedbugs are attracted to their hosts primarily by carbon dioxide, secondarily by warmth, and also by certain chemicals. Hungry or starved bedbugs will come out from their hiding places in search of food. When searching for a place to feed, these bugs can move very quickly. They seek exposed skin of a person or animal, preferably on the head and neck region, and also bite bare arms, hands and legs. When once an appropriate blood sucking site is found, they feed for 2 to 5 minutes or until full if not disturbed, and then move quickly away from the host into a hiding place. Under typical warm conditions, they try to feed at least 5 to 10 days intervals, and adults can survive for about 5 months without food. Newly hatched first instars can survive for weeks without taking a blood meal. However, there are reports stating that bedbugs can survive for 2 months without feeding. Mouthparts. Mouthparts are piercing and sucking type that includes rostrum, maxilla, mandibles, and labium. Bedbug injects saliva during feeding, which has anticoagulant properties. In order to overcome blood coagulation, vascular constriction, inflammation and pain sensation in the host. Pre-injection anesthesia and capillary dilation have evolved in different hematophagous species. Feeding physiology. A bed bug pairs host skin with the help of its rostrum. Rostrum is a beak-like structure composed of the maxillae and mandibles, which are modified into elongated needle-like style. The right and left maxillary stylets are connected at their midline, and a section at the center line forms a large food canal and a smaller salivary canal. The entire maxillary and mandibular bundle penetrates the skin. The mandibular stylet tips have small teeth which move alternatively back and forth through tissue to reach blood vessel during piercing. Pressure from the blood vessel itself fills the insect with blood in 3 to 5 minutes. The bug then withdraws the stylet bundle from the feeding position and retracts it back into the labial groove, folds the entire unit back under the head and stops feeding. Usually, sucking takes place 5 to 10 minutes for a bug to become completely engrossed with blood. In all, the bug may spend around 20 minutes in physical contact with its host. Blood feeding occurs at night, and they generally seek shelter during the day and become inactive while digesting the bed bug infestation. Bed bugs are small and very flat insects, hide easily into very tight corners and cracks. They occur most commonly in bedrooms. Bed bugs infestation occur in bathrooms, living rooms, and laundry rooms. Bed bugs infestations are found also under picture frames, in between the glass and the frame, and behind electrical outlet and other wall plates. The severe infestations can be noticed by observing the aggregations of bed bugs with eggs, nymphs, adults, cast skins and fecal spots. Sometimes dark blood spots appear on bed sheets and bedding material due to the bed bug feeding. Moreover, bed bugs excrete while they are feeding that result in appearance of dark reddish or brownish spots or smear on bed sheets, pillowcases and mattresses. The dark reddish material is composed of digested blood. Further, human dwelling places are commonly infested with bed bugs in a variety of ways, namely persons' clothing or luggage from infested place, furniture, backpacks from infested place, through ducts or false ceilings from infested place, from infested areas such as public transport, example air travel, train travel, etc., entertainment venue or lodging, carrying the bugs to another area on their clothing, luggage or bodies from infested place. Parasitic nature of bed bugs. Though bed bugs are strictly parasitic, they spend only a small period of their life cycles physically attached to hosts. Most of the time, they live away from their host but occur nearby bedding area. The Cimex species feed on bat, Cimex hemipterus infest poultry and bats. Leptocimex bouti infests bat and humans. Cimex pilocellus and Cimex pipistrella primarily infest bats, while Emetosiphon inodora infests poultry. Bed bugs are vectors. Bed bugs act as vectors, carry disease-causing pathogens. They can carry at least 28 disease-causing pathogens to human. However, there are no clear reports about the transmission of pathogens to human beings, but there are reports stating that bed bugs transmit arboviruses also. Interestingly, bed bugs are not transmitting pathogens of HIV, hepatitis B, hepatitis C, and hepatitis E. Simiosis, it is a skin manifestation, develops prominent blisters which occurs due to bed bug bite. Host of bed bugs. Bed bugs are parasitic insects, spend only a tiny fraction of their life cycles with hosts. Once they finish feeding, they relocate to a place close to a known host commonly in or near beds or couches in clusters of adults, juveniles and eggs. It is called arborages. Detection of bedbugs. Bedbugs are detected by their characteristic smell of rotting raspberries, fecal spots, that is small dark sand like droopings that occur in patches around nests, blood smears on sheets, that is re-wetted fecal spots, smear like fresh blood and empty molted exoskeletons, characteristic disagreeable odor when crushed. Effects of bedbug bite. Bedbug's bite causes several adverse health effects such as allergic symptoms, skin rashes, transmit pathogens and psychological effects. Symptoms. All people are not equally sensitive to bedbug bites. Some people develop rashes from the bites, others may not display symptoms. Usually, the symptoms are simple red spot to severe rash. Sometimes people unable to realize the bedbug's bite, they mistaken for other organisms such as fleas, mosquitoes and other biting insects. Diagnosis of bedbugs and their bite. It involves finding bedbugs and identifying the compatible symptoms. Treatment for bedbugs bite. It involves elimination of bedbugs and taking proper effective measures against the symptoms until they resolve. Control of bedbugs. Mechanical control. Bedbugs can be controlled mechanically by vacuum cleaning, heat treatment, hot water treatment, burning, applying molten wax, wrapping mattresses, combination of heat and drying, steaming, ant picking and killing, using domestic cloth, dryer or steam are most effective control measures used against bedbugs. However, for public health reasons, individuals are advised to call a personal pest control servicing agents to eradicate bedbugs in a multi-family building. Thus, home residents are discouraged from attempting to treat bedbugs themselves. Chemical control. Bedbug Cimex lectularis have resurged to quickly become a very important pest of the 21st century. It occurs in urban areas also. As of 2012, there were no effective pesticides available to kill and control bedbugs. In USA, DDT, chlorodane, lindane were used to eradicate bedbugs. In North America, bedbugs are almost completely removed as a result of mass treatments with older types of insecticides such as DDT, chlorodane and lindane. During World War II, bedbug problem was solved by fumigation using zyklon discoids that released hydrogen cyanide gas. Later, DDT was used to control bedbugs. Bedbug bombs or foggers are popular but are not effective when treating bedbugs. Biological control of bedbugs. There are reports available on natural enemies and predators of bedbugs. The fungus Bavaria bassiana is known to infest bedbugs and control their population. Further, traditional methods of repelling or killing bedbugs include the use of plants extracts such as black pepper, nilgiri oil, tobacco, wild mint and seeds of cannabis, etc. In the middle of 19th century, smoke from peat fires was recommended as an indoor domestic fumigant against bedbugs. Bean leaves have been used historically to trap bedbugs in houses in Eastern Europe. Integrated approach. The bedbug population can be controlled effectively by following an integrated approach. It includes potent pesticides application, increased public awareness, slum clearance programs, combined pesticide use with steam disinfection, relocation of slum dwellers to new houses. There are trained dogs employed to pinpoint bedbugs infestation with a possible accuracy rate between 11% and 83%. A few companies are experimenting with high-speed gas chromatography to detect bedbugs. Thus, Control of bed bugs frequently requires a combination of non-pesticide approaches and the occasional use of pesticides. Predators of bed bugs. Natural enemies of bed bugs include the masked hunter insect, commonly known as masked bed bug hunter, cockroaches, ants, spiders, mites, and centipedes. Uses of bed bugs. In Chhattisgarh, India, bed bugs have been used as a traditional medicine for epilepsy, piles, alopecia, and urinary disorders. However, this practice has no scientific basis. In 18th century, bed bugs were recommended to use in the treatment of hysteria. Conclusion. Bed bugs are aeterous insects, live as parasites at human residing places. They feed exclusively on the blood of warm-blooded animals, including man. They are nocturnal in nature, occur singly or in aggregations at places, preferably at the vicinity or inside beds and bedding areas, near luggage, within furniture, inside electrical sockets, and nearby laptop computers. Their infestations can be notified by observing the aggregations of bed bugs with eggs, nymphs, adults, cast skins, and fecal spots. Bed bug bite develops prominent blisters and it is called simicosis. Although bed bugs spend only a tiny fraction of their life cycles with hosts, produce several adverse health effects such as allergic symptoms, skin rashes, transmit pathogens, and develop psychological effects. Bed bugs can be detected by their characteristic smell of rotting raspberries, fecal spots, and characteristic disagreeable odor when they are crushed. The bed bug population can be controlled effectively by following mechanical, chemical, and biological means so that one can get rid of from the bite of bed bugs. Thank you.